Yesterday, a surprising email reached my inbox. OpenAI announced that the GPT-4o mini model is available, which is said to outperform GPT-3.5 and is also 60% cheaper. Furthermore, it supports not only text generation, but also has the vision capabilities of 4.0. This means we can send images and have them recognized and analyzed. And also impressive, we are talking about a 128K context window. This means we can send a lot of information and get a lot back. So, of course, I want to know if this small new model can keep up with the large model. To test the new model, I'll showcase three typical use cases I usually perform with GPT: text generation, vision capabilities, and autonomous agents. I have to admit that I was shocked by the results, and you'll soon understand why. For the first test, I create a new file, app.py. To be able to test it, I insert the simplest code we have to send a chat completion request to OpenAI. We use the GPT-4o mini model. We have a system role to control the behavior of the language model and a user role to submit the actual request. As a system role, I simply write that it is a world-class copywriter. As a user role, I tell it to generate a new AI product idea and craft an engaging headline and subheadline. Lastly, we output the result. We start the script with pythonapp.py and see that a response came very quickly. We notice that the smaller model is superior to the larger one in terms of speed. We have a headline with "Meet your AI wellness companion" and a fitting subheadline. Okay, so far so good. Let's raise the difficulty level a bit. For our second query, we will have an image analyzed. I have already prepared this. We take a simple screenshot of a landing page. We see it here from Adobe, and we want to have this landing page analyzed and suggestions for improvement given. For this, we have a similar setup. We have a chat completion with a content type text. How would you enhance the copy? Explain your reasoning. And we also actually include the image. We limit the number of output tokens to 300 and output the result. We run the script. This takes significantly longer. Okay, but we also get a much more detailed response. We see here various ways to improve the copy, such as making the headline stronger, mentioning USPs, improving the pricing information. Maybe a good opportunity to take this and send it directly to Adobe and perhaps get a consulting contract out of it. Well, I would say that so far the mini model has done a good job. It is very fast, and at first glance, there are no significant quality differences. Now we want to use a typical use case for GPT, namely creating autonomous agents. We'll make a very simple example. For this, I create an agent's PI file. We'll make a very simple example. There are two or three major frameworks that are often used for agents. The first was LangChain, which was among the first for agents. Then, of course, Microsoft's AutoGen. And relatively late came Crew AI, all of which have their different strengths and weaknesses. For simplicity, I will work with AutoGen. We start by creating the necessary imports. This means we want to set up an assistant agent, a user proxy agent, and a group chat manager. We need an LLM config. Here we use the language model, specifically GPT-4o mini. We set the API key via the environment variable, and then we can start configuring the different agents. We have a user proxy agent that collects feedback from the user when necessary and can also terminate the group chat. We want to create a copywriter agent capable of writing copy. We tell him, "You are a world-class copywriter." And we also want to include a product manager to improve the quality of the copywriter's work and provide tips. We tell him, "You assess the performance of the writer and give tips." Then we create a group chat with a maximum of 12 rounds. This means that when all participants have been involved a total of 12 times, the chat will end. We need a manager who determines who goes next, and then we can actually start the chat. We give a similar requirement, create a new AI product ID, and craft a captivating headline and subheadline for the landing page. The difference now compared to the simple query is that we have different agents working together in a group chat. Okay, let's try it out. First, I need to install AutoGen. Then we can start the chat via Python agent PY. And we see that first the copywriter goes to work. Then, after providing a product idea and headlines, the product manager joins in. And we can already see that it is very fast. For all of you who have worked with AutoGen before, this video is not sped up or anything, but this is the actual speed at which the responses come. At least I find it very fast, especially compared to what we knew before. At first glance, everything appears to function like a typical group chat between agents. There are no error messages, except for a warning that the model is not recognized by AutoGen, which means it cannot calculate the costs. And I would say that here too, the main points worked well. For those who have used AutoGen with local language models before, the selection of the next speaker often required function calling, which frequently didn't work reliably. However, this functionality worked flawlessly here, showcasing GPT-4o Mini's true strength in handling speaker roles effectively. And if it's 60% cheaper than GPT 3.5, this is definitely my new go-to solution for autonomous agents.